really loud. I apologize if any of you were in the theater that day. And so usually I feel like I know where things are going, and this was the first time I was really caught by surprise, and I thought, I watched this show. And I was like, but no one's gonna put this show on television, you know, like there's no way. And I met with Nicole and Eric, and they started to pitch out the whole show, and I thought, wow, I love them, I love the whole thing, no one's gonna make this show. And then we got a phone call that CBS had rented and they wanted to make the show, and we come in.
The rest was history. For the producers, can you, in the pilot, you introduced the idea that Siobhan knows a child named Sean.
That caused a huge rift between the sisters. You know, these were two women who were on parallel journeys, and through a series of bad choices, their paths started to diverge, and there's one inciting incident that caused irreparable damage, and it all plays into the mythos of that, and that's something that will, you know, unravel over the course of the first season and flashback.
And Nestor, you've been on a show before, obviously, that's filled with mysteries, and what advice can you give to the rest of the cast on how to handle it when fans come up to you and demand spoilers and answers?
I just give it up.
Very first professional thing ever was reading with Sarah. And I didn't
Sarah plays this huge and so cool
yeah.
movie work with her 10 years later. And it's literally
ten years
later. Yeah. It's kind of a full circle. So, yeah.
Yohan, had you ever heard of the CW? Be honest.
Again, we live and die by our twists and turns and secrets, but you know, at its core, like Sarah said, it's a tale of two sisters, where one is driven by redemption and one is driven by revenge. And we're also playing with the themes of identity and duplicity. So, you know, playing within the conceits of noir, you know, you don't know really who's the femme fatale, who's the mark, and everybody has two faces, and every single one of our characters on the panel has a duplicitous nature. So. We love delving into that realm of moral ambiguity instead of, you know, who's right, who's wrong, who's your hero, who's your villain.
I'm inside.
That's great. Well, I think we're ready to take audience questions. If people want to.
Jane, for a character like Bridget, where she doesn't know what's going on and she's not sure where her solid ground is.
Make sure it was open with
her. And also when in the beginning in that scene to remember that I can't kick him straight in the face and she doesn't know what she's doing. Sometimes I do have to get reminded of that.
Yeah, I did, I tried to.
Like he was like in this debonair tuxedo and the hair show, I mean, all of it. So it's just, it's a
presented. However, I have confidence in the creators and the writing team to know that there's going to be this really enjoyable ride. So while I expected this is very sort of, you know, sweet, kind of homegrown, you know, this big part of the TV show, Rainer feels like this. I mean, feel and with all due respect to Life Expected, because Life Expected, you know, has my heart, but Rainer feels like this amazing machine that's in motion. The script, when I read it, was like, heat, sexy, fun, and Sarah, like, you know, coming back to television. It just was a really cool thing. So there was a lot of things that kind of brought me to Henry. But he is a writer, and he is a little rumpled.
Hi, this is Christian and Sarah. First of all, I want to say I love you. You're amazing. In this role that you've got, siblings, like, I fight with my siblings all the time, so do you ask siblings of your own, or family members when you can get that reality of?
That's interesting, actually, because I don't have any siblings, and as an only child growing up, you do look at things differently, and so I've had to rely on both people that have siblings and people that have twins, too, because from what I understand, there's a very different bond between siblings and between twins, especially identical twins, because they lose a lot of their own identity within each other, and a lot of twins have told me that they don't feel, when their twin's not around, they don't feel completely whole, and so to have these sisters that were that close, who have not spoken in all those years, it's certainly been an adventure for me in understanding that relationship.
Nasty twists, which I'm looking forward to. Nicole and Eric, do you want to add anything to that? Will we be seeing some of Victor?